Hello, hello, welcome back to the garden. Okay, so I'm gonna let you know about what has survived and what has thrived, what has not, and what has died. I recently cut my bangs and they are just living their own life now. It's funky. Anyway, hello all of my beautiful friends. How are you all today? I hope you all are having a wonderful day. My name is Heather and I have to go to the dentist today. Not too excited about it because last week they numbed half my face. Now they're going to numb this half for doing a deep cleaning. Like, you got to do preventive maintenance. You got to do what you got to do. But I'm here thrifting because I got out of work a little bit early so that I could come to the thrift stores like a treat before I go to the dentist. Last week I was here and I found a seatbelt bag, but it was fake. It was fake. Don't worry. I would have freaked out and started filming if it was real. So let's go see if we can find a real seatbelt bag today. I'm manifesting it. Let's see if I can find one. I haven't found one in probably like 8 years in the wild. So let's find one today. Let's go thrifting.
Did you get a great job and advance my career? If you're interested, we have a
program. I could get a grass. Maybe about grass tarnishes, but don't need it. Oh, don't need it. Look at me.
Then look at these.
Somebody was looking at them too. They're already pulled out. But that's a no from me. What is going on with the knees back here? Jackson. Look at these knees. No. 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 I just sound like my daughter. No.
I didn't get the seatbelt bag that I wanted. Of course, you know, I manifest it. One day I'll find a seatbelt bag out in the wild again at a thrift, but not anytime soon, I don't think. But let me show you what I did find. I found this cute little like silverware holder and I love it because number one, it's $4. Number two, my mom has the exact same one and I want exactly what she's got. I'm super excited to have the same silverware holder that my mom's got. I also found this, which is like a little butterfly from the Girl Scouts. And I know it's from the Girl Scouts because of this little Girl Scout cookie, but also this Girl Scout tag, so that tells me it's brand new. So I got her this little butterfly. On Sunday, we're gonna go see the butterflies at the zoo, and I'm gonna pack this in my purse and give it to Joey as a little like gift right after we see all the butterflies. So I think that'll be really fun for her. I also found this little Build-A-Bear backpack. It's a little backpack that has a pocket in it, so you can actually wear your bear as like a little backpack, and you don't have to carry it around. This was only $2. I had to get it for her. And then they had this little packet of Pop-Its. They had a bunch of Pop-Its that were $3 for one, but this pack had two for $3. So I was like, ooh, $1.50 each, we'll take that for sure. And I like that they're smaller. I'm gonna put these in the dishwasher and disinfect them before I give them to her. I think I scored. I only spent like $12. on the four items. And I think Joey's gonna be really happy with her new little Girl Scout butterfly. Yeah, Girl Scout butterfly, that's what it is. Alrighty, I'm off to my dentist appointment. Maybe I should show you guys what my face looks like after I get out. Because last time half of it was just done and I was trying to sing like on my way home and there's just blood coming out. Maybe I'll record it. Oh, I mean, look, part of me looks kind of weird, like not being able to move my face. But the other part is like, I don't have any wrinkles. I don't have any wrinkles. Oh, this is too funny. Oh, I just got out of the dentist. I'm about to hit the road. Oh, but I wanted to show you guys what my face looks like after getting out, because you guys saw me what I looked like before when I went thrifting, and this is my face now. I don't want to drink anything because, like, it'll come out that side. Oh, it's hard to swallow even, but... Oh, I feel like it kind of looked like Two-Face from Batman. Yes, I'm so excited. You don't even know. So I have been looking for like lawn chairs or like some kind of lounger that I can use at my house. But the lounger needs to fold up because I don't really have much room to just have a lounger out all the time. So it'd be nice if I had a fold-up lounger. The thing is they used to make them back in the day. I feel like they were all over all the time. They had, you know, cute little plastic straps or like woven ones. I couldn't really find them anymore. And Target came out with some. I'm so excited. You have no idea how excited I am. Yes. On the app, it said that this store might not have any. And I was like, no. So I ordered one from the Oceanside store, but I'm just going to go ahead and cancel that order. Oh, we got one. Let me show it to you. I'm so excited. All over a little lawn chair. You know, it's when you're searching for something for a long time and you finally find it that you're like, yay, I got one. So exciting. So here's what it looks like. Whoa, it's super cloudy. So even though it's really cloudy right now, I'm going to set up my little chair and we are going to see how it looks. Might even put it by the container garden for right now. Let's see. Okay. It's so pretty, watch. What? Now look, you all know I am a pale queen, so we will not be sun tanning in this. No, I do not like the sun. Doesn't really work out for me. I mostly just burn. So this is really for just chilling and enjoying the backyard or the back patio. And I love that it folds right up super flat so that I can put it into the garage or even put it right behind my greenhouse and it's out of the way. So far, so good. I love it so much. So excited. Is she all done? Are you still feeding her? Is she all done? She all done?
Play.
I'll play it. So it just rained and I want to see how all of my plants are doing because last night it was really loud. I mean, the rain was really loud. So let's see how everybody's doing.
So it looks like our peppers are doing okay. Fresno chili peppers. Here we go. They're doing okay. They're not flooded out like they were before.
Our bonsai looks like she's doing well. Our other peppers are good. Our carrots are all right. We still got a few sprouts in. Our lettuce has been eaten by something. I think it was a snail, and I think I got that snail. Our loofah, I don't know where it's at. It's not coming. I don't think it's gonna come, but we're gonna just let it do its thing. Check out our strawberry here. I actually pulled this strawberry down. Sorry, check out this strawberry here. I actually pulled this strawberry down off the hanger because they said that there was gonna be high wind, so I, you know, was hanging up here before. So instead, I brought it down here to be okay and not flip over. Our mint, of course, she's doing great. Sweet corn, I may have planted too many stalks, but we're just gonna see how it goes. Let's see if we got a little, someone might have fallen over a little bit, but that's okay. We got plenty of other corn. Our sweet basil was eaten, and sadly, I think it might be gone. Our Roma lettuce was also being eaten by the same snail that was eating that other butter lettuce, but I think I saved it, and I think it's gonna grow back. It's gonna be okay. Our two tomato plants that we have here from my dad, I need to plant these. These need to get planted this weekend. But our other two bonsais right here, they look like they're doing great. They are doing really well. Oh, let's go look at the potatoes. Looks like they're doing good. I want to make sure they're not flooded out in there. Nope, not flooded. They're doing really good. Something's eating them though. We gotta find that culprit, get rid of them. But other than that, nobody is flooded. Everybody's out of their saucer so that they don't get flooded. Even our lime tree looks good. Oh, this guy blew away almost. So good.
That is the update on the garden. I'm sorry I don't look too good. I'm not wearing any makeup and I literally just got out of the shower so my hair is all stringy, but I just had a couple minutes before I had to get back to work and I wanted to check out the garden. Everybody looks like they're doing okay. I did have to move the trellises. I fell over. So I moved one on the outside of her house and one to the inside of her house. You do what you gotta do, you know? Hello, hello, welcome back to the garden. Okay, so I'm gonna let you know about what has survived and what has thrived, what has not, and what has died. The peppers are looking like they're doing really well. Carrots are, they're doing all right. Lettuce, I feel like it's coming back. She's coming back. Loofah. Oh my gosh, we have a sprout. We have a sprout. We hadn't had a sprout in a minute with the loofah. That's exciting. Strawberries are doing good. Mint's doing great. Basil is gone. I'm gonna call it. I think the basil has died. There's not even a bit of green here. I do need to plant these two tomato plants that my dad grew from seed, so I'm gonna do that. And I'm also going to put a couple more holes into the bottom of my Fresno chili bucket because this bucket floods every single time it rains, and that means that there's not enough drainage because all of the other buckets are fine. So I'm gonna put a couple more holes in this bucket, and I'm also going to put holes in this bucket to transfer one of the tomato plants in. I have a grow bag for the other tomato plant, but that's the plan right now. I've got the hot glue gun is heating up so that I can put holes in the bottom of these. So let's get to it. I also need to plant my beets and my cucumbers. I'm actually thinking about planting my cucumbers where my basil is, because the basil's dead. Basil's dead. So I might as well just plant a couple cucumber seeds in there and see if I can't get something growing in the container, right? But I have planned all along to have the beets go with the corn. I'm gonna try. Let's try it out. I think I'm just gonna stick it right into the corn. See how it goes. Put a couple of them in there. of the corn. You can see I've got quite a few stalks coming up. I really thought that only one or two were gonna actually come up. So I'm gonna plant these beets here in with the corn. Let's do it. See if we can't put some holes in the bottom of this guy to plant our tomato plants. Got my little name tags here. All right. Now they say cucumbers and beets. So now that this is heated up a lot, I can actually just easily, as you can see, put holes in this. So watch. Voila! Now we've got some holes. Got some good drainage. I think I'm just gonna do one right in the middle for good measure. One's gonna produce a bunch. I mean, they're both gonna produce a bunch, but one's gonna produce a crazy amount and another one's gonna produce a normal amount. Thank you. Look at her dress. Thank you.